I will show in this video how you can improve your XPS peak fitting following a few simple steps. I will use silicon 2P as an example, but I will choose in a general way so that you can follow these steps for any element. This is silicon 2P narrow scan. If you can remember, in the previous video, I have shown about silicon 2P. Identification, smoothening or noise reduction, basic fitting etc. Now, let's begin the fitting. Create a region. SI2P. Here comes the first important step. The background type. By default, the function is Shirley. I want to see how other functions will fit. I am changing Shirley to Silicon 2 Guard. To do that, I have to enter USI. It seems not bad. Let's check other functions similarly. Entering USIO2 to use USIO2 to Guard. This does not fit well. Next, changing to UAluminium 2 Guard, short form UAL. This looks okay. Let's see others too. This is similar to one of the previous functions. And the last one, UPolynomial 2 Guard, short form UPoly. A very little change. Let's change back to Shirley. I guess Shirley works better. Keep this in mind, Shirley will fit better in most of the cases. Because our SF values stand good with Shirley. So, in your second step, you should make sure our SF values are correct. Another factor which makes Shirley more usable than other, is that Shirley takes care of the asymmetry of the line shape near background. So, our next step, which should be your third step, is line shape. There are two basic peak shapes, Gaussian and Lorentzian. But, in most of the experimental cases, the shape is in between the Gaussian and the Lorentzian. Thus, the line shape is described by the forked function. The forked function can be in two forms, product form, and sum form. Additionally, the line shape can be asymmetric and exponential. While fitting, you need to know at least a few essential functions. GLP, which is a Gaussian-Lorentzian product formula, where the mixing is determined by M equals P by 100. For example, GL100 is a pure Lorentzian, while GL0 is pure Gaussian. SGLP, which is a Gaussian-Lorentzian sum formula, where the mixing is determined by M equals P by 100. For example, GL100 is a pure Lorentzian while GL0 is pure Gaussian. GLPTK, which is a Gaussian-Lorentzian product formula, modified by the exponential blend. SGLPTK, which is a Gaussian-Lorentzian sum formula, modified by the exponential blend. AABNGLP, which is a Gaussian-Lorentzian product formula, modified by an asymmetric form. Examples are shown in this figure. Here A is 0.35, B is varied from 0.2 to 1, N is kept 0. Considered as pure Gaussian, thus it is GL0. Let's try these line shapes, one by one. By looking at the shape, we can assume there are three peaks. And, we know from the previous analysis, there could be three peaks, 2P3 halves, 2P half and 1 oxide peak. Let's make it. This is the first component. It's 2P3 halves. Next, 2P half. Last one, 2P oxide. The position is not correct. Let's correct it. It must be here. 102.6. Now, we can check how they fit to data. Well, we can improve it. Look at the envelope and the data. Try to find where are the gaps between those. Here. And, here also. Here also, we can increase the Gaussian contribution, increasing 30 to 40. Seems better. Let's do it for other two also. Then, fit these. Looks better. We can try increasing the Gaussian contribution more. Let's use 60, this time. Better. But, kind of asymmetry is observable. Let's try with asymmetry. The function is a 0.35, 0.20. Adding it to the second one also. Now, the gap reduced. What if it is more of an exponential blend than the normal asymmetry function, what we have used? We can check it. Remove asymmetry and add exponential bend. We can try with 1.5. T1.5. Now, both the 2p3 halves and 2p half look fine. But, the oxide peak is not so. Probably, there is one more peak here. Let's add this. Now checking the fitting. This is great. Let's check the entire region closely. These two peaks can be a little broader, which means the Gaussian contribution. Make it 80. Also, I will increase the exponential factor. 1.6. Wow! This is better. Maybe, this oxide peak can be treated more. This left side is overestimated in the parameter. We can decrease the Gaussian contribution. Let me know in your comment if you want to try or practice with the data file, which I have used. I will stop here. See you in the next video.